there is only one time and all different times are parts of it. There is only one space and all different spaces are parts of it. There is only one matter and all different materials are different states of it. As such, it is called substance. Different times are not simultaneous but successive. Different spaces are not successive but simultaneous. Different matters, materials are not so through substance but through accidents. Time cannot be thought away, yet everything can be thought away from it. Space cannot be thought away, yet everything can be thought away from it. The annihilation of matter cannot be conceived, yet the annihilation of all its forms and qualities can. Time has three-day visions, past, present, and future, forming two directions with a neutral point of indifference. Space has three dimensions, height, breadth, and length. Matter exists, that is, acts in all the dimensions of space and throughout the whole length of time, and thus unites and thereby fills these two. In this consists the true nature of matter. It is therefore through and through causality. Time is infinitely divisible. Space is infinitely divisible. Matter is infinitely divisible. Time is homogeneous and a continuum. In other words, no part of it is different from another or is separated from it by anything that is not. Time, space is homogeneous and a continuum. In other words, no part of it is different from another or is separated from it by anything that is not. Space, matter is homogeneous and a continuum. In other words, it does not consist of originally heterogeneous homomeries or originally separated parts, atoms. It is therefore not composed of parts that would be separated essentially by something that was not matter. Time has no beginning or end, but all beginning and end are in time. Space has no limits, but all limits are in space. Matter has no origin or extinction, but all arising and passing away are in matter. By reason of time we count. By reason of space we measure. By reason of matter we weigh. Rhythm is alone in time. Symmetry is alone in space. Equilibrium is alone in matter. We know the laws of time a priori. We know the laws of space a priori. We know the laws of the substance of accidents a priori. Time is perceivable a priori, although only under the form of a line. Space is immediately perceivable a priori. Matter is merely conceived a priori. Time has no permanence, but passes away as soon as it is there. Space can't never pass away, but always lasts. The accidents change, the substance endures. Time is without rest. Space is immovable. Matter is indifferent to rest and motion, that is to say, originally it is not disposed either to the one or to the other. All that is in time has a duration. All that is in space has a place. Everything material has an effectiveness. Time has no duration, but all duration is in time, and is the persistence of the permanent in contrast to its restless course. Space has no movement, but all movement is in space, and is the change of place of the movable in contrast to its unshakable rest. Matter is the persistent in time and the movable in space. By comparing what rests with what is moved, we measure duration. All motion is possible only in time. All motion is possible only in space. All motion is possible only to matter. In equal spaces, velocity is in inverse proportion to the time. In equal times, velocity is in direct proportion to the space. With equal velocities, the magnitude of the motion is in direct geometrical proportion to the matter, mass. Time is not measurable directly through itself, but only indirectly through motion, which is in space and time simultaneously. Thus time is measured by the motion of the sun and of the clock. Space is measurable directly through itself, and indirectly through motion, which is in time and space simultaneously. Thus, for example, an hour's walk, and the distance of the fixed stars expressed as so many light years. Matter as such, mass, is measurable, that is, determinable, according to its quantity, only indirectly, thus only through the magnitude of the motion which it receives and imparts by being repelled or attracted. Time is omnipresent. Every part of time is everywhere, that is, in the whole of space simultaneously. Space is eternal. Every part of space exists always. Matter is absolute. In other words, it cannot come into being or pass away. Hence its quantity cannot be either increased or diminished. In time by itself everything would be in succession. Time renders possible the change of accidents. In space by itself everything would be simultaneous. Space renders possible the persistence of substance. Matter unites the unstable flight of time with the rigid immobility of space. It is therefore the permanent substance of the changing accidents. This change is determined for every place at every time by causality, which in this very way combines time and space and constitutes the whole nature of matter. Every part of time contains all parts of matter. No part of space contains the same matter with another part. For matter is permanent as well as impenetrable. Time is the principium individuationis. Space is the principium individuationis. Individuals are material. The now is without duration. The point is without extension. The atom is without reality. Time in itself is empty and without definition. Space in itself is empty and without definition. Matter in itself is without form and quality, and likewise inert, in other words, indifferent to rest or motion, hence without definition. Every moment is conditioned by the preceding moment, and exists only in so far as the preceding moment has ceased to be principle of reason or ground of being in time. By the position of every limit in space compared with any other limit, its position compared with every possible limit is determined absolutely and exactly principle of reason or ground of being in space. Every change in matter can occur only by virtue of another change that preceded it. Therefore, a first change and hence also a first state or condition of matter are as unthinkable as is a beginning of time or a limit of space. Principle of reason or ground of becoming. Time renders arithmetic possible. Space renders geometry possible. Matter, as the movable in space, renders phronomy possible. The simple element of arithmetic is their unit. The simple element of geometry is the point. The simple element of phronomy is the atom.